like this.
He's walked in the courtroom as a lawyer. You would just have an impression. What in God's name is he doing with his sunglasses on? And who does he think he is? What's with the pinky ring? I put that on because obviously this case has gotten some publicity. I became known as some pinky ring wearing attorney. It's actually my dad's high school ring. It's never been on my pinky, but that's all it takes is an impression. And we look at people and we keep that with us. So you might have an impression of George Zimmerman. Stand for a second. You might have an impression of him because he's sitting at the defense table. And that maybe, as we talked about, he's not just a citizen accused, but maybe he is a defendant. Maybe he has something he has to defend. Maybe, in fact, that because the state attorney's office has decided to charge him, he has to have done something wrong. Maybe that's an impression that you have. Unfortunately, we're not going to ask you not to have impressions. That's absurd. My fear, as I was telling you about it, is that if that allows you to sort of diminish or minimize your task that you've taken on here, that it works against my client. Because when we talk about things like common sense, we want you to use your common sense, but be careful with your common sense. I know it's a dangerous thing to say. Be careful with your common sense, because common sense is the way we run our everyday lives, the way we make those snap decisions that we have to make every day in order to work, in order to live, in order to deal with our children and our parents. I mentioned as an example, driving today. I guess you guys didn't drive today, but we did. You know, you presume people are going to drive in the lane and not just cut you off. It's these assumptions that we make. The problem with it.
Excuse me, I am so sorry. One minute.
Okay.
There's Twitter again.
Oh, nice. Well,
sorry.
That's okay. I appreciate you noticing.
Thank you. I'm sorry to interrupt.
No problem at all. I think that, well, we'll wait now because it may have to be restarted, but I'm just going to chat for a bit, so I'll get back to it. My concern is that it may in fact work against my client, because if you start using those same processes that we're used to every day, that just look at things, make a decision and move on, that subtly and unintentionally you're going to minimize or diminish the standard that has to be applied in this case.